Korea dates from the 13th century. The legs managed to run clockwise on both sides of the flag, carried here by Steve Partington. His fifth games. His wife is in her third. They're both race walkers at 20 kilometers. She's actually done better than he has. Her highest was sixth, and his highest is seventh. She's in her third games. Canadians enjoying it in the middle. Air Marshal Ian McFadden, Lieutenant Governor of the Isle of Man. Of the great Don Quarry, who won 6 gold medals in the Commonwealth Games. Sandy Richards is in the 400 metres, the age of 34. No Jerry Horton though in the 400 metres, he's in dispute with his federation, which is a bit sad for him and for them.
Still got a good team though, Barry. They'll win lots of medals, particularly on the track.
Their 13th games, they've got 26 gold among 66 medals, 4 gold in Kuala Lumpur. Flag of Jersey, the flag in the hands of Ian Coombs, good fellow, who is competing in the badminton. In a parade of 72 countries, David Obiero, a weightlifter. And the question for you, Steve, is there to be another clean sweep from 800 meters up in the men?
Well, they said so last week, that's what they predicted. I'll predict one thing, they'll win a clean sweep in the steeplechase, they always do, with Commonwealth, World or Olympics, but they will be strong.
And indeed in the women this time.
Indeed, we'll be relying on the likes of Paula Radcliffe to take on Edith Masai, who Kenya have high hopes for in the 5,000, but certainly they are the favourites in the 10,000 marathon. So, as we would expect, lots of medals for them there.
Ah, the country, Kiribati. Not spelled like that, but that's how it's pronounced, let me assure you. The former Gilbert Islands in the northeast of Samoa in the Pacific. And here's Maria Tediaki, the weightlifter. Second games, just 3 in the team in Kuala Lumpur. Former Basutoland, independence in 1966. Constitutional government in 93 after 23 years of military rule. Flag bearers in the marathon, 42 in the team. Helpers alongside, certainly the friendly games. Wonderful hats. Rising sun indicating a new beginning on the flag of Malawi. It's carried by Lawrence Arthur, who's in the lawn bowls. Made their debut in 1970 in Edinburgh. Won 3 bronze, all in boxing. Maldives, southwest tip of the Indian subcontinent, 420 miles from Sri Lanka. Third games, no medals yet. They got a shooter up front. Of the George Cross awarded them by George VI in 1943. Maltese flag here carried by William Cecuti. Another shooter. Going to be busy down at Bisley. Only medal was bronze in the judo in 1990. It's their 12th games. Lovely island of Mauritius. Their uniforms, though, designed by one Anita Williamson, formerly at the Helensburgh Athletic Club, graduate of the Glasgow School of Art. She's lecturing in Mauritius in their School of Design and has designed this outfit. Team. First medals in their ninth games were in Kuala Lumpur.
Make some noise for Montserrat!
And away from Spider-Man and on to Montserrat. Gavin Lee, who's in the high jump. Hope you wait for the games to start.
Mozambique!
You all know the flag bearer here, one Maria Mutola. Well, we're supposed to be, but she's back. She's well, in the 800 metres of Olympic champion there.
She may well have decided, Barry, that competing in the next day or two, not to take part in the ceremony, but as you said, expected to easily defend cycle over 800.
But I am absolutely sure this is Paulus Ali Numbembe, welterweight boxer from Namibia. Sir Bobby Charlton and Lady Charlton to his left.
Frankie Fredericks waving to the crowd there. Frankie, favourite in the 200 and may well stop our guys in the 100 as well. Still going strong at the grand old age of 32.
Nauru from Oceania. 40th team, and here's Marcus Stevens. You won one gold in 1990, two in 94, three in 98. He's a weightlifter.